Okay, you bring water wherever you go. Number one. Okay. Number two is, when it's 115 degrees outside, don't go sit in your car with shorts on. Don't do it. That's another thing I've learned. Burn my bottom. Okay. Number three, and this is a new one. This is a new one, right?
Okay.
This is what you were expecting, right?
Come on.
So, okay, Hollywood fashion secrets. Gentle fashion tape, people. Go get it, okay? $2 at CVS. It is fashion tape to tape up your shirt, okay? You don't need to put a sock in there anymore. You just tape it. You're good to go. So that's secret number three. Use it, do it, CVS, okay? All right, so what have I learned in Orlando? What has Orlando taught me? All right, so some of you know a little history about me, some of you don't, but I've lived here for 6 years.
Woo!
Okay, so I was baptized in the Portland, Oregon Church, right? Wow, I was living in Washington State, so I would drive 3 hours each weekend to go to church.
Come on.
So, as I was baptized, a month of months, I moved here. So I was baptized there, and I still lived 3 hours away from the church, and then we moved to Florida. So I've never actually been in a church, right? Like, I didn't go to midweeks, I didn't go to Bible talks. And it was most Sundays we did make. But this has been like my home so far, right? Like you're like my spiritual, like my growth, right? Like I grew up here.
Come on, Trisha.
We all come from New York, okay? I grew up here spiritually.
Okay, come on.
While living in Orlando, oh man, I have struggled, okay? And if you knew me back then, when I moved here, I was 8 months pregnant with Aurora, a newlywed, just gotten out of a military career, and moved across. If you don't know where Washington is, okay, it's like over there, over here, okay? So I moved across the state, okay? And this is all in like a very short couple of months.
Yes.
So I was, what's a good uplifting word to tell you how I was?
Hot mess.
It really was. I feel like I didn't get like how or what it meant to actually truly be a disciple to like, it's going to be embarrassing, like years later. Like really, I was just on the struggle bus. All the time. And I was like, SOS, like, Helen, like, my marriage is going down. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Who do I talk to? What's happening? Like, I just didn't get it. So that's the struggle, right? So I struggled, but I learned.
Come on.
How to be a godly wife.
Come on.
I became a mother of four precious babies.
Five.
Wow.
Five. Yeah. I obtained my associate's degree from Seminole State, my bachelor's degree from UCF, and I'm working on my master's.
Woo!
I have weighed 300 pounds since I've lived in Orlando, and I've weighed 200 pounds since I've lived in Orlando. I have gone through people leaving, so this church could plant three other churches in Florida.
Come on.
And well, sending various other people to different churches around the world. Yeah. I've co-led different Bible talks with my husband John, and we have run the children's ministry.
Yes, thank you.
So many things, right? I've learned what it means to be a friend. I hope.
Right. Come on. Great
friend.
But I've also learned what it means to be hurt by a friend.
Come on, Trisha.
Many things have happened since I've lived in Orlando. The one of I was trying to think of like your topic kind of thing, you know? But the one that just kind of called out to me the loudest, that I have learned to trust and constantly grow in my relationship with God. And that's my relationship with God. That it's no one's responsibility, not the kingdom, not the leaders.
Come on.
Not my husband.
Yeah.
It's nobody's responsibility other than my own.
Come on.
To not have a bitter heart.
Come on.
And not have a hard heart.
Yes.
Those are things I do struggle with. You know, I mean, military in New York, like, just get over it. Okay, just come on. Nobody's doing that to me. So why would I do that to other people? So, but it's nobody's responsibility other than my own. Yeah.
Come on.
That's my choices. Those are my issues that I need to wrestle with God. Like,
yeah.
He is not wrestling them for me. Like,
no.
That's me.
Yeah.
It's all me. Even though she could. It's still me.
Yeah.
Come on, Church.
Hang on. Siri wanted to hop on there for a minute. So what I did was, I'm going to go through these kind of fast. You don't have to turn to them if you want to turn to them. If you're, like, really quick on it, you can. But if not, just write them down. So I went through, like, kind of like the key scriptures that have, like, got me through.
Come on.
That I've been able to go back on day by day, hour by hour.
Come on.
And that these are scriptures that have really helped me dig and create my own convictions that are in line with the Bible. Like, even though, like, John has, like, awesome, you know John's awesome, right? But he has, like, his own awesome, solid convictions on stuff. And I'm just not like, okay. it's not me. Like, I want to be one day, but it's not me now. So I had to build my own convictions on a couple things.
Okay, come on.
All right, so this one, 2 Corinthians 5-17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come and the old is gone. The new is here. Oh man, you guys, I was a mess. Like a mess. I was a drug addict. I was so many bad things, right? And like made so many bad decisions.
Come on.
That it took so long for me to drill in my head that I am not that person anymore.
Not. Come on, Trisha.
I was so brand new and white with God.
Amen.
And that took so much after years of telling me, people telling me what a screw up I am, how embarrassed my parents were of me. Just, it took so long. And you think, like, God's words are like, oh, okay, yeah, sure, okay. But no, it took forever to drill that into my brain that I am a new creation with Him.
Come on.
Okay, and then all of Proverbs 31. Okay. this one I always keep on me because this helps me be a better wife is Proverbs 31:23. Her husband is respected at the city gate, where he takes a seat among the leaders of the land. I have learned to try my best. To say only uplifting things about my husband.
Come on.
Because, and you know, John is a man to be respected.
Man.
Right? He is a godly man, and he deserves nothing but to be respected, especially by me.
Come on.
So that has always stayed right there. Proverbs 31:25, she is clothed with strength and dignity. She can laugh at the days to come.
Come on.
Having four kids, you need to learn to do this, okay? You don't have an option, okay? You just don't. I mean, even just kids in general, you don't have an option. This must be something that's in there. Just learning to enjoy life. Be happy, laughing at what happens. Okay, my tire blew. Let's go. What's next? It's life. Like, it's,
come on.
It's uncertainty, but it's guarded by God, so I'm okay.
Come on.
Right? Colossians 3:23.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart. As working for the Lord, not human masters.
Mm.
Be a hard worker.
Come on.
I was not a hard worker. Like, not. I've been fired from like 20 jobs. I was not a hard worker. Okay. But this world is not my home. Like, this is not. I'm just blessed to be here. Like, I don't have to be here, but he's giving me the option to be here and make the most of it.
Yes.
For him.
Amen.
Come on, Trish. 2 Corinthians 6:14.
Okay,
guys, this is gonna be. Okay. Do not be yoked together with unbelievers.
Come on.
Oh, you guys. If anything has been the deepest and hardest conviction that I've had to learn, it's this one. Okay, so I came into the kingdom married.
To John.
Yeah, to John. never married before, other than to John, and then having a new baby. So I did not, like, I never belonged to a DSF or a LIT. Or like, this was not our serenity. Thank you. This was never like part of God's plan for me. Like, I never got extravagant proposals or like dates or all this like kingdom stuff. Like, all this stuff, it's part of this, like, it's beautiful.
Mm.
It really is something beautiful. And so I came in like, oh, I wish I had that. Like, oh, so I'm just like, I don't have these close-knit friendships, right? Because, like, I was already with John, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, I didn't have like a best friend to be with all the time. Like, John was my best friend. And Kathy, his mom. She's still my really good friend, but she was my best friend. It was Kathy. So I held on to these relationships that were outside the kingdom, like my battle buddies from basic training, friends that I had like grown up with since I was 2 years old, and just over the years, like striving to keep a relationship with them while being righteous and godly and being at peace and here with what they're doing, what's going on in their lives, even though you try and do what you can, it's still there, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it gets like harder and harder and harder and harder. And I used to say, I was a brat. And I would be like, it's so stupid. My best friend's gonna be out in the world, and this is my best friend, and she'll always be my best friend, and I don't need best friends in the kingdom. Friends are fine. And like, I was so bent on keeping my friends out here that I wasn't working on the friendships in here. So a lot had changed, and I don't know what happened, but I came to like this epiphany one day, a parade, right? I'm working on relationships in the kingdom, right? To be with like-minded people.
Come on.
It's just, I'm much happier working on this than constantly working on this.
Yeah.
Even though I'm a light to my friends that are outside the kingdom, I'm putting the bulk of my effort in here.
Come on.
You guys. So that, it that one was hard, right?
Come on, Trish.
And I hope you guys understand that. If you don't, I can possibly explain it more eloquently when it's just us. But that's that.
Yeah,
all right, the next one. one is Exodus 23:14. Ooh, never appear before the Lord empty-handed. Right? Ooh. All right, so I was given the chance a couple years ago to do my first benevolence at midweek by Helen. And I gained this conviction. I've learned to pray about it every Wednesday morning. Pray about it, okay? So you can tattoo it on your heart to remember to bring benevolence. Even though that I do fail sometimes, right? We all make mistakes. There goes mercy, right?
Yeah.
I really do try and appear and never appear before the Lord empty-handed. So that was one I learned too, because John's like the finance guy, right? So he does all the money. I'll do money. So it was something that I had to learn. I had to make it my own conviction.
Right.
So I think that's kind of like the cool part about having the women's midweek and the men's midweek. So even if like Sheena does like all the money for them, like it's still Devon's conviction to, you know, give benevolence on his men's midweek. So we still get the option and the choice of our free will to like make those options and make those convictions for ourselves.
Yeah, come on.
All right, this one's Sonia showed me. And it will stay with me forever. 2 Timothy 1:7. For the spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. Okay, I needed this one more than ever in the past 2 years, since I've gone through many transitions and refinement during that time. But it was perfect. God put Sonia in my life at the perfect time, because I needed that. And then, this is the last one, Psalms 145:13. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Your dominion endures through all generations. The Lord is trustworthy in all that he promises and faithful in all that he does. You guys, the kingdom is jewel, right?
Yes.
The kingdom, even though it's filled with all sinners, okay? and it's not... even though it's filled with sinners, God's plans are perfect, right? Like we can strive to be perfect. I'm not perfect, but God is perfect.
Yes.
So God makes the kingdom perfect.
Come on.
Yeah.
Awesome.
So I've learned that most things that I go through can simply be solved by what? Tap more faith, right? Do it.
Come on.
Being vulnerable.
Come on.
And forever being humble. I will be moving August 5th. We are moving to Denver, Colorado. John graduates on the 4th, and then we move the next day.
Wow.
So I wanted to let you guys know that in case you didn't know. But I love you all very, very much. And you will be.
Aww, yay! Well, you will be missed too.